فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد. My beloved brothers and sisters, ولله الحمد والمنة, praises to Allah alone. We thank him and we also send salutation on his Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. We've completed the first article of faith, Al-Iman Billah. And now inshaAllah ta'ala, we're going to move on to the second article of faith, that without it, a person is not a believer. You are not allowed to disbelieve in the angels. And it is a pillar from the pillars of Al-Iman. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, he says in the Quran, وَمَنْ يَكْفُرْ بِاللَّهِ وَمَلَائِكَتِهِ وَكُتُبِهِ وَرُسُلِهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ فَقَدْ ضَلَّ ضَلَالًا بَعِيدًا. In that verse, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, he tells us, وَمَنْ يَكْفُرْ بِاللَّهِ, anyone who disbelieves in Allah, وَمَلَائِكَتِهِ, and his angels. And at the ending, what did he say? فَقَدْ ضَلَّ ضَلَالًا بَعِيدًا, that person has become misguided, a very serious misguidance. He's a disbeliever. Because at the beginning, وَمَنْ يَكْفُرْ, who disbelieves in Allah. So you're not allowed to disbelieve in Allah, nor are you allowed to disbelieve in the angels. So inshallah ta'ala, as you can see on the board, I've written these points inshallah ta'ala. The first one is what's in the middle. And that is, لا يتجاوز, we are not allowed to surpass. We are not allowed to avoid and leave off. في التعريف, when it comes to the definition of the angels, بهم القرآن والسنة, we're not allowed to go against the Quran and the Sunnah. In other words, if you want to speak about the angels, who are they, what are they, you have to go to the Quran and the Sunnah. The reason is because the angels are, as we're going to define later, عَالِمٌ غَيْبِي, they are an unseen universe. لَمْ نُشَاهِدْهُمْ, we never saw them. وَلَا نَذِيرًا, and they also don't have anything we can resemble them to. So all of these things that you watch on television and you see on television, they are not a correct portray of the angels, because we don't know how they look. And they have nothing that we can compare them to. So it's an unseen world. So the only place in which we can find the reality of the angels and what they are and is from the Quran and the Sunnah. And we're going to take that now inshaAllah ta'ala, what the Quran and the Sunnah has told us about the angels. Once I do that, bi'idhnillahi al-kareem, I'm going to be speaking about these two, starting with this one, and then inshaAllah ta'ala, making this the second point, bi'idhnillahi al-kareem. So first of all, let me speak about, or let me define what the angels are. As I said, the definition of the angels is as follows. They are an alim, they are a alam ghaybi. Fahum alam ghaybi. They are a universe that is unseen. No, none of us have actually seen it. لَمْ نُشَاهِدْهُمْ, none of us have seen them. وَلَيْسَ لَهُمْ نَذِيرٌ, and they have nothing for us to compare them to. There isn't. فَلَا يُمْكِنُ, then it is not possible for us to know them and to understand them. إِلَّا عَنْ طَرِيقِ الْكِتَابِ وَالسُّنَّةِ, except through the book of Allah and the Sunnah of the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم. Now what did the Quran and the Sunnah tell us regarding the angels? Number one, the first one that the Quran and the Sunnah has told us regarding the angels is, the first thing it's told us is that they are ruhaniyun. The The first thing that the Quran and the Sunnah has indicated to us is that they have a soul, they have a ruh. As Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He says, فَأَرْسَلْنَا إِلَيْهَا رُوحَنَا فَتَمَثَّلَ لَهَا بَشَرًا سَوِيًّا. The angels, they have arwah. Number one. Number two. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala created them. From what? Allah tabarak wa ta'ala created them from min nur, light. The second thing that we know about the angels is خلقهم الله عز وجل, that Allah created them من نوره, from His light سبحانه وتعالى. أما من نور, from light. As Allah سبحانه وتعالى, He says خلقت الملائكة من نور, that the angels are created from light. The hadith is collected by Imam Muslim in his Sahih. The light that's here is a light created by Allah تبارك وتعالى. Allah created that light سبحانه وتعالى. Also, the third thing that we know about them is لا يأكلون ولا يشربون. The third one is لا يأكلون, they don't eat. ولا يشربون, and they do not what? And they do not drink. As Allah تبارك وتعالى, He says about them in the Quran, وَلَقَدْ جَاءَتُ رُسُولُنَا, our messengers, they came to Ibrahim bil-Bushra. They came to Nabila Ibrahim with glad tidings. قالوا سلاما. Ibrahim said to them, peace on you. قال السلام. فما لبث أن جاء بعجل حنيد. Nabila Ibrahim, time did not go by until he came with what? بعجل حنيد. He came with a piece of large amount of meat. He placed it in front of them. And Nabiullah Ibrahim, Allah tells us, فَلَمَّا رَأَى أَيْدِيَهُمْ لَا تَصِلُ إِلَيْهِ. When Nabiullah Ibrahim saw that their hand was not going to that direction, Nabiullah Ibrahim, نَكِرَهُمْ, he was in a state of fear. He was also what? This is not an act. وَلِذَلِكَ, the Arabs, they used to have a concept which is, if a person didn't eat your food, it was as though they were bringing you bad news. It was a war. You wouldn't turn down a person's food. So Allah tells us in the ayah that the angels, they didn't push their hands forward to eat the food. Because the angels, they don't eat. They do not eat, based on that verse. The third thing that we know, the fourth thing that we know from them is what? They are azimu khilqah. What we also know is they are azimu al-khilqah. They are what? They are very big in their creation, and they're very strong and they're large. As the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said in Hadith Sunan Abi Dawud, أُذِنَ لِي, I was permitted, أَنْ أُحَدِّثَكُمْ, to narrate to you, to inform you, عَنْ مَلَكٍ, an angel, مِنْ مَلَائِكَ, from the angels who are مِنْ حَمَلَةِ الْعَرْشِ, those who are carrying the throne of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then the Prophet told us, بَيْنَ شَحْمِ أُذُنِهِ, the flap of his wing, from his ear, to his shoulders, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he told us, is a what? مَسِيرَةُ سَبْعُمِئَةَ عَام. It's a distance of how much? 700 years. Just between the shoulder and the ears. And that shows us what? That shows to us how great and how big these angels of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are. The other thing that we know of them is, which is number five, is that Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He created them ala suratin jameela, beautiful. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He created them ala surah jameela, in a very beautiful form. As Allah tabarak wa ta'ala told us in the Quran, ذو مرة فاستوى. And as we know, ذو مرة means manzarin hasan. Their appearance is just amazing and beautiful. They are very beautiful. وَلِذَلِكَ Allah تَبَارَكَ وَتَعَالَى He said about the women who came together of Nabila Yusuf and they were cutting their fingers off when they saw the beauty of Nabiullah Yusuf عليه الصلاة والسلام. Allah تبارك وتعالى He told us that they said قلنا حاشا لله ما هذا بشرا إن هذا إلا ملك كريم. This man is not a normal human being. He's an angel. He's an angel. So the reason why they refer to him as an angel is because the angels are a creation who are beautiful. So they are beautiful. The other thing that we know about them, which is number six, is that they have lots, they have what? لهم أجنحة. What we know about them is they have wings. As Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala, He says to us in the Quran, جاعل الملائكة. Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala is the one who made جاعل الملائكة رسلا أولي أجنحة مثنى وثلاثة ورباع. Allah made subhanahu wa ta'ala for the angels wings. أجنحة, wings. مثنى two, وثلاثة and three, ورباع and four. And also other characteristics that have been told to us, that which they in, that the fact that they come down, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He told us that. Allah also told us subhanahu wa ta'ala that they hear and they see. Allah told us that subhanahu wa ta'ala, and etc. So those are the definition of the Quran and the Sunnah regarding the angels. Now we have the definition of the angels, that they are alam, they are an alam ghaybiyun, a universe that we've not seen, okay? An unseen universe, and also there is nothing for us to compare them to because we don't know them. What we also know is that the way to know the angels is through what? Through the Kitab and the Sunnah, and no other way. When we look at the Quran and the Sunnah, from the things that it tells us are these six and of course many others, but these are from those things in which the Quran and the Sunnah tell us regarding the angels. So now we finish this point, which is having understanding of the angels is through the Quran and the Sunnah, and these are the points in which a slave can find out and understand the angels. And don't worry, I will be speaking about, inshallah ta'ala, maybe in this session, in this class, or maybe another class, inshallah ta'ala, I will be speaking about what effect should it have on you believing the angels. How should that affect your heart and your iman? And without a doubt, inshallah ta'ala, we will be speaking about that bi'idhnillah al-kareem. Believing in the angels. Believing in the angels is of two types. An iman which is mujmal, a belief which is general, generic, comprehensive, and a more detailed belief which is iman al-mufassal, is more of a detailed belief. And inshallah ta'ala, I'll explain what the difference is bi'idhnillah al-kareem. Let's go to al-Iman al-Mujmal. Iman al-Mujmal means that you believe in the existence of the angels. And this belief, which is al-Iman al-Mujmal, is the qadar, is the limit. If you don't come with that much, you're a disbeliever. You are a disbeliever. If you don't believe that the angels exist, and you say, I don't believe that, then you're a disbeliever, you're a kafir. Because you go against the ayat that I mentioned, the verse Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala, He says, وَلَقَدْ أَرْسَلْنَا رُسُولَنَا, we sent our prophets what? إبراهيم بالبشرى قالوا سلاما قالوا سلاما فما لبث أن جاء بعجل حنيد فلما رأى أيديهم لا تصل إليه نكرهم. So this ayah is clearly telling us that the angels came to Nabila Ibrahim. So when you say I don't believe in the angels, you're rejecting this verse. And also you fall under the ayah which I mentioned before in Surah An-Nisa. Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala, He says, وَمَنْ يَكْفُرُ بِاللَّهِ وَمَلَائِكَتِهِ وَكُتُبِهِ وَرُسُلِهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ فَقَدْ ضَلَّ ضَلَالًا بَعِيدًا. وَمَنْ يَكْفُرُ بِاللَّهِ وَمَلَائِكَتِهِ وَكُتُبِهِ وَرُسُلِهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ فَقَدْ ضَلَّ ضَلَالًا بَعِيدًا. So your disbelieving in the angels has been mentioned right next to disbelieving in Allah. But the limit of belief is al-Iman al-Mujmal. You have to believe in the existence of the angel. Okay? You have to believe in the existence of the angels, that they do exist. And rather, the disbelief of the angels wasn't something very common. Even those who disbelieved in the Prophet ﷺ, who disbelieved in the resurrection, who didn't want to take the religion of Islam, they did believe in angels. Qawm Ad, if you look at them, Thamud, if you look at the people of Lot, if you look at the people of Nabi Muhammad, Quraysh, they believed it. That's why they said to their prophets, what did they say? وَلَوْ شَاءَ اللَّهُ الْأَنزَلَ مَلَائِكَ. If Allah willed and wanted to send a message to us, then He would have sent an angel. Why is He sending you instead of? Why is He sending you and not an angel? You see? So disbelieving in the angels is a view held by a minority. The overwhelming Umam, they believed in the angels. So it means to believe in the existence of the angels, that they exist and that you don't reject them. That's what it means, al-Iman al-Mujmal. Al-Iman al-Mujmal entails, and it means, al-Iman bi-wujudihim, that you believe there are angels that exist. That's it. That is the minimum that's needed from a person. If you come with that much, you're a believer. And you've come with the articles of faith. Then what's needed from you is the second point that I'm going to be speaking about. And it's more, inshallah ta'ala, explanation is, al-Iman al-Mufassal. Al-Iman al-Mufassal is a bit different now. Iman al-Mufassal is believing that comes from taba'an lifahmi al-kitabi wa sunnah. A person understood the kitab and the sunnah and he read the religion more. He now understood some extra things pertaining to the angels. Then it becomes obligatory on that person to believe in those. So this is taba'an linusus al-kitabi wa sunnah. It's actually extra things that a person starts to believe regarding the angels. And inshallah ta'ala, as you can see on the board, I have written three things that are needed to believe. The first one is al-imanu bi asma'ihim, is to believe in their names. So you actually believe the angels in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned. From them Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He mentioned, ala sabili tamthil, hey, who can we say? Angels that Allah mentioned them by name in the Quran. We find Allah mentioned Jibreel. So number one, we have Jibreel. Hiya. We have Mikael. Hiya. We have Malik, who is Khazin al-Nar, right? Hiya. We have Munkar wa Nakir. We have Harut and Marut. And etc. Right? We have Malakul Maut, and we leave it at that point because some people call Malakul Maut what? Izrafil. I mean, Izrael, they call it, right? They call it Izrael. That we don't accept because why? The reason why we don't accept that is because the agreement was what? In order to know the angels and to actually affirm them, you had to go through what? لا يتجاوزوا في التعريف بهم القرآن والسنة. You can't go, the Quran and the Sunnah is only what says it. So this name Israel is not a name which we affirm. لِأَنَّهُ لَمْ يَرِدْ نَصٌ مِنْ كِتَابِ مِنَ الْكِتَابِ وَالسُّنَّةِ بِذَلِكِ. There's no verse in the Quran or the Sunnah that actually proves that point. But rather the Kitab and the Sunnah, rather what's mentioned is Malakul Maut, the angel of death. So we don't use that name Israel that the people call it. So the first one is الْإِيمَانُ بِأَسْمَائِهِمْ. Now that I know after reading the Quran and I read the Sunnah, I see names like Jibreel, Mikael, Malik, you know, Munkar wa Nakir, Harut and Marut, and etc. I am now going to believe those names. I'm going to believe they are angels from Allah. And now this belief is actually more detailed. So you have to believe them because they are verses from the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The second is al-imanu bi sifatihim. You are actually now going to not just believe. You're not just going to believe their names, but you're rather going to move on that they have characteristics and their appearance and how they look. And an example would be Jibreel, right? Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, or the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has told us that how many wings does he have? Situmi'at janah. He has what? He has situmi'at, he has 600 wings. Jibreel. And other characteristics, and some of them we did mention before. So we believe that now. This is the characteristics of Jibreel specifically. We believe it. We believe it because there's a clear-cut evidence regarding it. So this falls under al-Iman, al-Iman al-Mufassal, and it specifically falls under al-Imanu bi-sifatihim, believing in the great characteristics of this noble prophet, this noble angel of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The third one is al-imanu bi-a'malihim. Oh, roles that they have, responsibilities and duties that they have. For example, we know that Jibreel is what? Muwakkalun bi-ish. What is his responsibility? Bil-wahi, revelation. So Jibreel's job was to send revelation on prophets. To send revelation on what? On prophets. So we know that, and we believe that. We also know that Mikael, for example, he's muwakkalun ish? Bil-qatri, the rain. Mikael's role is, and the responsibility that he has, is the rain. We also know what? Malakul Maut is what? Malakul Maut is responsibility, ama he's muwakkalun bil-qabdi al-arwah. His job and his responsibility is to take the soul of the people. It's an angel of death. And also from the angels are those who are commanded to write, as Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala, He says, أَمْ يَحْسَبُونَ أَنَّا لَا نَسْمَعُ سِرَّهُمْ وَنَجْوَاهُمْ بَلَى وَرُسُلُنَا لَدَيْهِمْ يَكْتُبُونَ. So Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala tells us that the angels here, وَرُسُلُنَا is our angels, يَكْتُبُونَ, they are writing. And other than that, from the actions of the angels, we believe them then. We believe the names, we believe their characteristics, and we also believe in the actions and the responsibilities that those angels are given. So my beloved brothers and sisters, inshallah wa ta'ala, we're now going to speak about وننتقل إلى مسألة مهمة. We're going to now move on swiftly, inshallah wa ta'ala, onto a very important issue. And that issue is وهي it is أثر, the effect that believing in the angels, الإيمان بالملائكة, has an أثر على اعتقاد العبد وسلوكه. Believing in the angels has actually got an effect on the person's عقيدة, and it also affects the person's سلوك, their actions. So it's not just the issue which is theoretical. It's not قضية which is نظري فقط, that we just learn the angels' names and whatnot, but it actually affects our actions, and our إيمان increases from these angels. And inshallah ta'ala, that is what I'm going to be speaking about now. Here I said, وَيُثْمِرُ الْإِيمَانِ, the fruits that come out from الإيمان بالملائكة, believing in the angels, the out effect and the benefits that come out of it, عَلَى سُلُوكِ الْعَبْدِ, the tradition, the person's suluk, his manners and his, the way he carries himself, his heart becoming soft from it. All of that, what does it do, believing in the angels? So I mentioned two, inshallah ta'ala. The first one being al-iqtida bihim. We actually take them as role models and we follow them. We follow them because فَإِذَا كَانَتِ الْمَلَائِكَ مُطِيعِينَ لِلَّهِ. Because if the angels are ones who obey Allah and they never disobey Him, فَإِنَّا نَقْتَدِي بِهِمْ فِي طَاعَةِ اللَّهِ, we actually follow them. We actually follow them, فَإِنَّنَا نَقْتَدِي بِهِمْ فِي طَاعَةِ اللَّهِ, in the obedience of Allah. As Allah says to us in the Quran, لَا يَعْصُونَ اللَّهَ مَا أَمَرَهُمْ وَيَفْعَلُونَ مَا يُؤْمَرُونَ. They never disobey Allah, and they do as they are told to do. Allah also tells us, يُسَبِّحُونَ اللَّيْلَ وَالنَّهَارَ لَا يَفْطُرُونَ. They exalt Allah day and night, and they never come to a time where they stop or they relax. That's not how the angels are. They are in consistent worship of Allah. So they are our role models. They are the ones we take as our guides and our role models. So once people say to you, I don't have a role model, he's actually confusing or he's lying to himself. Because you do have role models. You have role models who are perfect. You have a role model who you want to set yourself a goal in following them. That's very important, my beloved brothers and sisters. So when we read what the angels are doing, it's actually something we want to do. We want to be like that. We want to obey Allah like that. Because they are creations of Allah. And so are you a creation of Allah? So set yourself a high goal. وَلِذَلِكَ إِبْنُ الْجَوْزِ رَحِمَهُ اللَّهِ, he says in his book Sayyidul Khatir, he says, كَمَالُ الْعَقْلِ, كَمَالُ الْعَقْلِ, عُلُوُّ الْهِمَّةِ وَالرَّاضِ بِالدُّونِ دَنِي. The believer, or the person who's smart, you want to know someone who's smart, who's clever, who you can say, you know what, this person is intelligent, you know, is an individual who has high aspirations. وَالرَّاضِ بِالدُّونِ دَنِي, And anyone who is, he has low aspirations, he doesn't have that high aspirations, then he's low. That he's dani, he's dim-witted. He's an idiot. The one who is intelligent and he's smart and he's clever is the individual who has high aspirations, unwavering conviction that he wants to get there. You see? Also, he says, وَمَنْ تَكُنِ الْعَلْيَا هِمَّةَ نَفْسِهِ فَكُلُّ الَّذِي يَلْقَى فِيهِ مُحَبَّبُ. Anybody who has high aspirations, he set himself a goal. He's like, you know what? That's where I'm heading. That's what I'm going to be doing. That's what I want to do. I'm not going to be settled with anything less than that. Anyone who sets himself a goal like that, what happens to him? فَكُلُّ الَّذِي يَلْقَى فِيهِ مُحَبَّبُ. Everything that comes in the way of whilst he's trying to get to this, in the way the pains and the suffering and the fallings and the tripping and the problems and the scars that happen to him is actually something he likes. He enjoys it. He laughs at the marks that happen to him. He's like, yo, I had a scar one time when I was doing this. And he's happy. He doesn't even feel it. He enjoys it. He laughs about it. Because his brain is in the sky. And his legs are on the earth. He's not on the level of these people. So that's why it's important to set yourself a high goal. And setting yourself a high goal is to want to be like the angels. Na'am, the angels don't have free will in the sense where Allah tabarak wa ta'ala created them to be like this. But why would you set yourself a low goal anyways? Try to compete with creation who are like that. So iqtida bihim, imitating the angels, acting like what they do. You see, فَإِذَا كَانَتِ الْمَلَائِكَةُ مُطِيعِينَ لِلَّهِ فَإِنَّنَا نَقْتَدِي بِهِمْ فِي طَاعَةِ اللَّهِ. The second thing is نَخَافُ مِنَ اللَّهِ وَنُرَاقِبُهُ. We fear Allah. نَخَافُ اللَّهَ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى. We are actually scared of Allah a lot. And we observe Allah in the things that we do. Why? لِأَنَّهُمْ يُسَجِّلُونَ أَعْمَالَنَا. Because the angels are the ones who are documenting. يُسَجِّلُونَ أَعْمَالَنَا. They're the ones who document, writing our وَيَكْتُبُونَهَا. And they're the ones who are writing it. The angels are actually writing what we're doing, and they are writing what we're saying, and they are writing what we are. All of that is things that they are documenting. And we don't want these obedient creation of Allah, kiramin barara, righteous slaves of Allah, obedient to Allah. We don't want to make their ears hear that which is not right. We don't want them to see that which is not good. We don't want to put those obedient creations of Allah in those situations. So we are actually scared of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. And we are fearful, and we know that there are angels he has sent to us, subhanahu wa ta'ala. As I said before, أَمْ يَحْسَبُونَ أَنَّا لَا نَسْمَعُ سِرَّهُمْ وَنَجْوَاهُمْ بَلَىٰ وَرُسُلُنَا لَدَيْهِمْ يَكْتُبُونَ. The angels are writing everything which you're doing. They are documenting. So you are scared consistently and in a state of fear. You know, don't be like from those who are scared of people who can see them. يَخْشَوْنَ النَّاسَ. They fear the people and they're concerned about the people. But when it comes to Allah, they're not concerned. They are not worried. They don't have that fear in them. Don't be like that. So these angels of Allah, tabarak wa ta'ala, they are writing our deeds and our actions and our speech. So one is always consistently on his toes and he's always focused and he's vigilant. That's the effect that it has on our iman. It affects our suluk, our manners and the way we carry ourselves. And also it affects our aqidah, our belief. That's part of it. There are many more other things that are in there. But since this series is basically a muqaddama, an introduction, inshallah ta'ala, we're now going to swiftly move on to the things that nullify your belief of the angels. What are the things that if you do or you come with, it actually cancels out and it deletes your belief of the angels. So I'm going to be moving on to that, inshallah ta'ala. We're now, inshallah ta'ala, going to go to the last point regarding believing in the angels. The last point regarding believing in the angels. And that is, نَوَاقِضُ الْإِيمَانِ بِالْمَلَائِكَةِ. The nullifiers of believing in the angels. What are the things that can nullify one's belief of the angels? So there's 5 points that I mentioned on the board. We're going to go through each one with its evidence, inshallah ta'ala, and bi-idhni Allah al-Kareem, expand on it if it needs explanation more, inshallah ta'ala. The first thing that can actually nullify a person's belief of the angels is al-imanu bi-ba'dihim duna ba'd. If a person says, I believe in some of the angels and the rest, I don't want to believe in them. So accepting some angels and rejecting other angels can, and it does, nullify one's belief of the angels. As Allah tabarak wa ta'ala said in the Quran, قُلْ مَنْ كَانَ عَدُوًّا لِجِبْرِيلَ فَإِنَّهُ نَزَّلَهُ عَلَىٰ قَلْبِكَ بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ مُصَدِّقًا لِمَا بَيْنَ يَدَيْهِ وَهُدًى وَبُشْرَىٰ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ. Allah also says, subhanahu wa ta'ala, مَنْ كَانَ عَدُوًّا لِلَّهِ وَمَلَائِكَتِهِ وَرُسُلِهِ وَجِبْرِيلَ فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ عَدُوٌّ لِلْكَافِرِينَ. So Allah referred to the ones who have hate for some prophet, angels, like the Jews. The Jews, they didn't like Jibreel. They didn't like Jibreel. And so they rejected Jibreel as an angel, and they only accepted those which they wanted, or they believed in Mikael. Because they said Mikael sends down the rain, and the rain is of Ben, but Jibreel, he sends down punishments and destroys nations. We don't like him. So they rejected Jibreel, and so these verses came down regarding them. Also, اعتقاد, to believe أنهم يستحقون العبادة, to actually believe that they deserve to be worshipped, or that they have some rights of ibadah. That is not what the angels are about. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He tells us that وَلَا يَأْمُرَكُمْ أَن تَتَّخِذُوا الْمَلَائِكَةَ, the prophets, they are not ones who command you, أَن تَتَّخِذُوا الْمَلَائِكَةَ وَالنَّبِيِّينَ أَرْبَابًا أَيَأْمُرُكُمْ بِالْكُفْرِ بَعْدَ إِذْ أَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ. So this ayah clearly tells us that Allah tabarak wa ta'ala and the prophets are not ones who command the people to what? To take the angels or they themselves, to take them what? To take them arbab, rabb, that are worshipped, no. وَلَا يَأْمُرَكُمْ أَن تَتَّخِذُوا الْمَلَائِكَةَ وَالنَّبِيِّينَ أَرْبَابًا أَيَأْمُرُكُمْ بِالْكُفْرِ بَعْدَ إِذْ أَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ. So you're not going to be commanded, and it goes against our religion, and it goes against Tawheed. Ibadah is for who? Allah alone. We spoke about that. So you cannot believe that the angels have any tasarrufat, they have any rights in ibadah. No. They are slaves. As Allah tells us, subhanahu wa ta'ala, بَلْ هُمْ عِبَادٌ مُكْرَمُونَ. They are slaves who are honorable. Now we're going to speak about that point, inshaAllah ta'ala, that the angels are, وَقَالُوا اتَّخَذَ الرَّحْمَنُ وَلَدًا سُبْحَانَهُ بَلْ هُمْ عِبَادٌ مُكْرَمُونَ. Sorry, وَقَالُوا اتَّخَذَ الرَّحْمَنُ وَلَدًا سُبْحَانَهُ بَلْ عِبَادٌ مُكْرَمُونَ. بَلْ عِبَادٌ مُكْرَمُونَ. They are noble, righteous slaves of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they don't have no rights of ibadah. So keep that in mind. The next third point, which is اعتقاد, believing أنهم بنات الله. There are some who believe that the angels are the daughters of Allah. And Allah refuted them in the Quran. He says, أَفَأَصْفَاكُمْ رَبُّكُمْ بِالْبَنِينَ وَاتَّخَذَ مِنَ الْمَلَائِكَةِ إِنَاثًا إِنَّكُمْ لَتَقُولُونَ قَوْلًا عَظِيمًا. Allah says in that verse, أَفَأَصْفَاكُمْ رَبُّكُمْ بِالْبَنِينَ وَاتَّخَذَ مِنَ الْمَلَائِكَةِ إِنَاثًا. That you, because the what they would do is, the kuffar of Quraysh, is that they would bury the girls and they would look down at girls. So they chose the boys for themselves, and they chose for Allah the girls. So in their eyes, they gave Allah what was low, and they chose for themselves to have boys. So that's what Allah tabarak wa ta'ala is saying. And also Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He says, وَجَعَلُوا الْمَلَائِكَةَ الَّذِينَ هُمْ عِبَادُ الرَّحْمَنِ إِنَاثًا أَشَهِدُوا خَلْقَهُمْ سَتُكْتَبُ شَهَادَتُهُمْ وَيُسْأَلُونَ. They say Allah's slaves who are righteous, they are slaves of Allah, righteous slaves of Allah, they said Allah took them as His daughters. Allah says, were they present when this was taking place? They will be asked about this claim of theirs and the statement that they put forward. They're going to be asked the Day of Judgment regarding it. So we're not allowed to believe in it, and we're not allowed to have that thought. The fourth is اعتقاد أنهم يعلمون الغيب المطلق, believing that they know the unseen unrestrictedly, and we don't accept that for anyone. قل لا يعلم من في السماوات والأرض الغيب إلا الله. قل لا يعلم من في السماوات, no one knows what's in the السماوات والأرض الغيب إلا الله, وما يشعرون أيان يبعثون. No one knows that. Also Allah تبارك وتعالى, He tells us, وعلم آدم الأسماء كلها ثم عرضهم على الملائكة فقال أنبئوني بأسماء هؤلاء إن كنتم صادقين قالوا سبحانك لا علم لنا, لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. So the angels, they claim, they say, لا علم لنا, we have no knowledge except that which you told us, oh Allah سبحانه وتعالى. The last one is, the last point is تنقص الملائكة. تنقص الملائكة. And تنقص الملائكة means that you belittle the angels and you put them down. And that is من كان عدوا لله وملائكته ورسله وجبريل وميكال فإن الله عدو للكافرين. If you have enmity and hate towards them, and that you belittle them, and that you put them down, also that nullifies your belief of the angels. And those are the five things that if a person finds it in himself, and that they are present in him, he should remember, or she should remember, that this is something that can nullify your belief of the angels. Anything which I have said that was wrong, a mistake, a shortcoming, a fault, a slip of a tongue, all of that is from me. And Allah and His Messenger are free from it. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayh.